All right, let's talk about getting real results from AI. You sometimes banging your head against the wall, getting back generic, useless stuff. You're not alone. The problem isn't the AI, it's often the prompt. Prompt engineering. It's the skill that separates AI masters from AI dabblers, and it's not some mystical art. It's a set of techniques that you can learn. In this episode, I'm going to show you a framework that will change how you prompt any large language model, and it's called RICCE, R-I-C-C-E. In the first two episodes of this mini-series, we explored the power of Gemini, and we compared it to ChatGPT. We established that AI can be a game-changer for your business, but you've got to know how to drive it. Think of it like this. You can have the most powerful car in the world, but if you don't know how to drive, you're not going anywhere. Recently, my wife and I invested in an electric vehicle, an affordable 2023 BMW i4 that we actually had to go to Atlanta to pick up and drive home. Obviously, I knew it was an electric car, so we wouldn't be using gas to fuel it, and I've driven hybrids before, but this was my first time driving a full EV, and it was quite a bit more different than I expected. In order to even put it in gear and drive, there's a button on the gear shift knob that has to be pushed first after you've already started the car. Without a little bit of instruction on that unassuming button, we wouldn't have gotten our shiny new car off the lot. So today, we're diving deep into prompt engineering so that you know exactly how to get your shiny new AI moving in the right direction. I'm going to break down the RICCE framework. It's how I approach prompting, and it's incredibly effective. I'll show you how to use each component to get the exact output you need from Gemini or really any LLM. And here's the cool part. RICCE isn't meant to be complicated. Think of it as training wheels. It's a way to build those good prompting habits. Eventually, you won't even need to think about it. You'll just be prompting like a pro.
Mike's got the hat, the AI kind. Unlocking power in business, you'll find. Cut through the hype, explore the tech. Every week, new ideas to check. Allton leads us on a digital quest. AI secrets, he'll always invest. Tune in tight, don't miss a beat. Knowledge groove, keep you on your feet. Listen up to the AI flow. Business growth, here we go. Cutting edge insights, that's the plan. With the AI hat, you'll understand.
Okay, let's start with R. That's for role. This is where you tell Gemini, or your AI, to act as a specific person or expert. It's like giving it a character to play. Why does this work? Because AI is trained on vast amounts of data. It has access to a lot of different personas. When you assign a role, you're tapping into that knowledge base and guiding the AI's tone, style, and even its expertise. Imagine you need a marketing plan. Don't just say, write a marketing plan. Instead, say, act as a seasoned marketing strategist with 20 years of experience in the e-commerce industry, develop a comprehensive marketing plan for our new online store. See the difference? You're giving Gemini a role, you're giving it expertise, and you're giving it context. The output will be way better. Now, here's how the AI Work Buddy helps. When you set it up properly, it bakes in a lot of that role information, so you don't have to repeat yourself every time. It's like having a chief of staff who already knows your preferences and communication style. By the way, if this is the first time you're tuning in and you're not familiar with the AI Work Buddy concept, it's a simple idea. What if we each had our own customized and personalized AI assistant that already knows everything about our work, our responsibilities, even our communication preferences? Having an AI Work Buddy is like being able to lean over to the next cubicle and ask your colleague, whom you've worked with for years, a question or even vent about the boss. There's a link in the show notes to learn how to set up your own AI Work Buddy for free, or simply go to theaihat.com/AI Work Buddy. Next up is I, instructions. This is where you tell Gemini exactly what you want it to do. Be clear, be concise, and leave no room for ambiguity. Think of it like giving directions. Go down the street and turn left is much better than go that way. The more specific you are, the better the outcome. Instead of write something about our product, try write a 150-word product description for our website, highlighting the key benefits and features. Don't be afraid to break down complex tasks into smaller instructions. If you're writing a blog post, you might have separate instructions for the introduction, each section, and the conclusion. Prompt libraries are great for this because you can create templates for common instructions. So instead of retyping the same thing every time, you just select the template and fill in the details. Your prompt library could be as simple as a Google Doc or a folder of Evernote notes. And if you're using Magi, which I highly recommend, it has a built-in prompt library you can fill up. I'll share a list of prompts for marketers, business leaders, and sales associates you can try using in the show notes to get your library started. Context is king or queen in prompting. This is where you provide Gemini with all the background information it needs to understand the task. Think of it as briefing a new employee. The more context you give, the more relevant and accurate their output will be. This includes information about your audience, your brand, your goals, and any other relevant details. For example, if you're asking Gemini to write an email, provide context about the recipient, the purpose of the email, and any previous interactions you've had with them. So you don't just say, write an email to John Smith. You'd say, write a follow-up email to John Smith, who attended our webinar last week and expressed interest in our premium service. The goal of the email is to schedule a consultation. This again is where the AI Work Buddy really shines. It stores all that crucial context information, your brand voice, your target audience, your communication preferences. So Gemini always has it on hand. This is the biggest time saver. The next C is for constraints. Now, constraints are limitations or guidelines that help Gemini stay focused and deliver the right kind of output. Think of it as setting boundaries for a project. Constraints can include things like length, tone, style, format, keywords, or specific requirements. They help you control the AI and prevent it from going off track. Instead of write a blog post, you'd try write a blog post under 500 words using a conversational tone and including the keywords AI, productivity, and small business. Constraints are also great for formatting. If you want a table, tell Gemini. If you want bullet points, tell Gemini. Don't leave it to chance. The Work Buddy helps you define and apply constraints consistently. You can set default constraints for different types of content so you don't have to repeat them every time. Or say rules like don't use emojis all the time or don't use the word delve. Now, the E in RICCE is for example or evaluation. This is where you provide Gemini with examples of the desired output or tell it how to evaluate its own work. And this is super powerful. Examples are like showing Gemini what you want. If you want a specific writing style, give it a sample article. If you want a certain tone, give it a sample of that tone. Evaluation is telling Gemini what makes good output. And you could specify criteria like make sure the writing is persuasive, focus on the benefits, or avoid jargon. You could even combine them. Here are two examples of effective product descriptions. Make sure your description is as concise and persuasive as these. The AI Work Buddy helps you store and reuse your best examples. You can create a library of successful outputs and easily reference them in your prompts. Now, here's the secret sauce. Prompting is an iterative process. Don't expect to get it perfect on the first try. You need to experiment, provide feedback, and refine your prompts until you get the results you want. Think of Gemini as a collaborator. You need to communicate effectively, provide guidance, and give it feedback. The more you work with it, the better it will understand your needs. If you don't like the first draft, tell Gemini why. Be specific. Make it more concise. Add more examples. Change the tone to be more formal. This is where the real magic happens. As you iterate and refine, you'll build your own library of killer prompts that consistently deliver amazing results. Now, are there any prompting techniques that are uniquely Gemini? The truth is, RICCE and most other prompting principles apply to any large language model. But Gemini's strengths give us some interesting angles. First, Gemini is multimodal. It's designed to understand and work with different kinds of information, text, images, audio, video. This opens up some cool prompting possibilities. Instead of just saying, write a caption for this image, you could upload the image to Gemini and say, analyze this image and write three different Instagram captions, each with a different tone, funny, professional, and inspirational. You can even ask Gemini to describe an image in detail and then use that description to generate text, which is incredibly powerful for accessibility and for creating content for visually impaired audiences. Second, Gemini integrates deeply with Google Workspace. This lets you craft prompts that pull in information from your existing documents and workflows. Imagine you're in Gmail. You can prompt Gemini to summarize this email thread and create a to-do list in a Google Doc, or extract the key data from this Google Sheet and write a report in a Google Doc. This kind of cross-application prompting can save you a ton of time and streamline your workflow. Third, Gemini's deep research capability is a true game changer, and I don't use that phrase lightly. You can use prompts like research the top 3 competitors in our market, compare their pricing and features, and summarize their customer reviews. This goes beyond simple web searches and allows Gemini to synthesize information from multiple sources, giving you a comprehensive overview. I run research prompts like this all the time and then share the results with my AI work buddy, also known as Clue, my AI chief of staff, to inform strategic conversations. Basically, anytime I want to do something I've never done before, or maybe I'm not confident that I'm doing it well, I can use deep research to surface current best practices, recommendations, trends, and resources, then share that report with Clue as a basis for strategizing my own plans. Since Clue already knows everything about me, my business, and my audience, he can instantly synthesize the report data and help me apply it to my own business context. The key takeaway here is that while RICCE provides a solid foundation for any LLM, you can adapt and expand it to leverage Gemini's specific strengths, especially its multimodal capabilities and Google Workspace integration. Now, I've mentioned the AI Work Buddy a few times, so let me explain why I'm so passionate about it. It's more than just a document. It's a system for mastering prompt engineering. Think of it as your personalized AI command center. You set it up once with all your key information, your role, your context, your constraints, and then you can use it to generate highly effective prompts in seconds. The beauty of the AI Work Buddy is that it allows you to focus on the instructions. You don't have to keep repeating yourself or providing the same background information every time. It's like having that assistant who already knows exactly what you want. It also helps you apply the RICCE framework consistently. It provides templates and examples for each component so you never forget a crucial element. This significantly improves the quality and consistency of your prompts. And here's a huge benefit. It facilitates iteration and refinement. You can track your prompts, your feedback, and the resulting outputs, making it easy to see what works and what doesn't. Is it really necessary? Can't you just use a regular document? You could, but the AI Work Buddy is specifically designed for prompt engineering. It streamlines the process, saves you time, and helps you achieve better results. I'm telling you, mastering prompt engineering is one of the most valuable skills you can develop in the age of AI, and the AI Work Buddy is your key to unlocking that skill. If you're ready to take your AI prompting to the next level, I encourage you to check out my AI workshop in a box. It's a comprehensive training program designed to equip your entire team with the knowledge and skills to use AI effectively. In the workshop, we spent a significant amount of time on prompt engineering, covering RICCE in detail, along with advanced techniques and best practices. We also provide hands-on exercises and real-world examples to ensure everyone can apply what they learn. Whether you're an AI beginner or an experienced user, the AI Workshop in a Box will empower you and your entire team to communicate more effectively with AI and achieve your business goals. To learn more about the AI Workshop in a Box and how it can transform your team's AI skills, visit theaihat.com. You'll find all the details there, and you can even book a free consultation to discuss your specific needs. All right, let's recap. Prompt engineering is the key to unlocking the true potential of AI, and the RICCE framework is your roadmap to mastering that skill. Remember, role, instructions, context, constraints, examples, or evaluation. Use it consistently. Iterate and refine, and you'll be amazed at the results you can achieve with Gemini and other LLMs. And don't forget, you can download the guide to setting up your own AI Work Buddy for free by following the link in the show notes. Thanks so much for tuning in. I really appreciate you investing your time and learning about this stuff. The future is AI, and with the right skills, it's a future you can shape. Welcome to the grid.
That's a wrap on another episode of the AI Hat Podcast. I hope you gained some valuable insights and actionable strategies to boost your business with AI. If you enjoyed the show, please subscribe, leave a review, and share it with your network. And don't forget to visit theaihat.com for more resources and to connect with me. Until next time, keep innovating, and remember, the future of business is human and it's powered by AI.